Ramaswamy went nuclear. He destroyed every single person on that stage. He destroyed the Republican establishment. He went after the moderators. He went after the entire system. He basically said the quiet part out loud. He said what a lot of people were thinking, but didn't have the balls to really say. And yes, it's sort of like Trump in 2016. In the first debate, he went on, came out strong. He grabbed my attention. The second debate, he sort of toned it down. And people like Nikki and whatever, Nikki Haley and whatever, were able to score some points. They're talking, they're the neocon talking points. But in this debate right here, he took no prisoners. He went after Nikki Haley, described her as being Dick Cheney in heels. She wasn't the only one either. He talked about how her family profited off of the defense industry, talked about the neocons and their support of Ukraine and how Ukraine wasn't a democracy. He basically stated a lot of the stuff that I've been thinking for a long time. He just said it on stage, and it was absolutely incredible. I sort of wish he was doing all this consistently throughout the entire campaign. I wonder if it's too late, but he even went after the RNC for losing again. For me, I think the RNC, the Republican Party, exists to suppress conservative movement in this country. I think they're here to sabotage any real attempts to make this country conservative. I think that's why they have this culture of losing. And he did describe this the Republican Party as a party of losers. And not only do I agree with that, I think they're really in place to lose. I think that's why they're really in place. So I thought it was absolutely incredible. I think that the Republican Party would probably be a lot better off going with this guy. I don't think he's going to be the nominee. I don't think it's going to... Maybe he might be the VP. A lot of you guys are convinced that he's running for VP, but the Republican Party, a lot of people in this party, especially the Romney Republicans, which, by the way, a Romney Republican is the head of the RNC, they're comfortable with the Republican Party doing what it's doing, and that's losing. I mean, so you got to ask yourself, why are they really in place? What is their real agenda? So anyway, you guys share your thoughts on that. I know a lot of you guys think that, oh, he's just too smooth. He's too like, okay, guys. Okay. Is that really the issue here? Okay. A lot of people don't. Anyway, I'm not going to even go into all that. But it was incredible to see somebody go on stage and actually call people out on their BS. And I absolutely loved it. So I would love to see a Ramaswamy versus Trump debate. I would love to see that. You know, that's something I think would be really fascinating. So I hope we actually get that. Anyway, in the news, I want to go back to the whole housing situation. I was talking about that earlier. Housing affordability has hit a 39-year low. A 39-year low. And a lot of you guys are saying that demand's the issue. There's a big demand for the housing. A lot of you guys brought up illegal immigration and... I'm sure it's a factor. I think the biggest issue is that millennials can't really afford homes. They can't afford homes because their wages aren't matching up with inflation. The cost of everything is going up. Okay. They're struggling to pay for everything, including groceries and including the vehicles and all this other stuff. The cost of everything is going up, up, up. And then, you know, they try to pay rent or they try to pay... they try to pay rent, and these companies are demanding, hey, your income must be three times that of rent. I mean, you know, they didn't try to save for a down payment in the middle of all that, you know. So, and then they try to compete against BlackRock and all these other entities coming onto the market, buying up stuff. They can't compete, and then there's interest rates which are sky high, which make the housing significantly more expensive, especially if you get a 30-year loan. So all this together makes it very difficult for young people to actually afford a home. And a lot of you guys pointed out that the baby boomers are not in their 50s. They're more in their 60s and 70s. Thank you for pointing that out. The main point of that Meredith's argument is that people in their 50s are going to start to downsize. And they may do that. a lot of you guys say that, oh, well, the boomers and people in that age group, whatever that is, that they're not going to voluntarily downsize. But here's the deal. What if it's not voluntary? What if it's not voluntary? So we may not see a voluntary downsize, but I think downsizing is often a necessity. So that's something we may end up seeing. Okay, speaking of Ukraine, there's more drama coming out of Ukraine. It's mostly conflict within the government itself. So there's conflict within the government itself. I talked about that a little bit earlier, yesterday. It's just a matter of time before that whole system just collapses. And I'm wondering if Odessa is going to be under the control of the Russians. Maybe the Russians will be okay with that staying with Ukraine. All those people died, and for what? Ukraine could have been neutral. Could have avoided all this mess. Anyway, let's go to the Israel situation. The rebels in Yemen they've been firing rockets at Israel. Well, recently they took out a U.S. drone, and the U.S. government didn't really want to admit this, but it happened. They took out a U.S. drone with a Soviet system, Soviet air defense system. They took out a U.S. drone, and it's just another reminder that our assets in the region are not untouchable. So I'm hoping this situation doesn't expand. But again, I'm thinking about World War One. You know, these world wars don't necessarily just happen overnight. Sometimes it takes a few months for things to really kick off. But I'm hoping, be prepared. Do your best to be prepared either way. I mean, how do you prepare for World War III? How do you prepare for something that big? You just got to be prepared for basic emergencies. That alone will put you in a better position to deal with things that come your way. It's better than doing absolutely nothing. So something to keep in mind. So Ramaswamy versus Trump. I mean, are you at a point where you even think that it's even worth looking at? I think it's definitely worth looking at. I would definitely love to see that. So guys, share your thoughts on this. The housing crisis, affordability crisis, really. I mean, this is why Trump is doing better than Biden in these polls. People are just sick of it. They look at their lifestyle. They look at their wealth or lack thereof. They say, I'm worse off than I was in 2020. You know, but, you know, I'm still convinced they're going to do everything they can to put Trump in jail. I mean, you know, after the Russian collusion stories, the lies about that, which Ramaswamy called the media out on that, this system, they're going to do whatever they can to make sure that they get the result that they want. They're not going to let 2016 happen again unless it's a different guy, unless it's Ramaswamy. But did the last debate have any impact on who you would consider voting for? Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.